Keeping track of your digital resources is important so that you can build upon your knowledge base. Especially when there's so much digital information, it can be difficult to keep track of that interesting article you read or some other snippet of information you want to hold on to. Notion can be a useful tool for this because of its all-in-one versatility and web clipper capabilities. In this video, we'll be showing you a Notion tour and tutorial of our Resource Hub Notion template, including our AI version. If you find this helpful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. So when you first download this template, on the left-hand side, you'll see all of your topics, and we've already pre-included all of these topics, but of course, you can also add your own here. And on the right-hand side, we have our resource database, which you can see by date added, by type, whether or not you need to review anything, and uncategorized. And uncategorized is the type of topic that's going to be automatically added when you add something to the resource database so that you can then categorize it. So first, let's go over how to add a new topic. So when you want to add a new topic to your Resource Hub, you simply have to go here and click plus new. And once you do that, you can name the new topic. So let's say that you're now interested in languages. So we can put languages and we can go ahead and open it up so we can start editing it a bit. So first, let's go ahead and add an icon. So maybe some kind of speaking, something like this could be nice for languages. And then you can also add tags if you need to this. And then you can start adding new resources to your languages. So once we have that ready, we can click out like this. Next, let's go over how to add a new resource. So to add a new resource, all you have to do is click the new button here, and it's going to add a new resource. So let's say that we're learning Notion right now, and we want to learn about how to add a resource hub in Notion. So let's put resource hub with Notion. The type would be an article. And here you can add the URL. So let's say that we're on our blog here and we want to store this information about the best tips to organize your resources with Notion. So we could go ahead and put the URL here. You can put a description here if you'd like and whether or not you need to review it. And once you have that, it's going to automatically put it to uncategorized. So then we can actually unlink that and now add it to Notion like this. And inside here, you can add that resource. So if we go back here, let's say that we just want to copy some of this in. We can simply copy what we need, paste it in. If you need to sort of highlight important information, you might want to, for example, highlight using Notion. So for example, if we just wanted to highlight this, you can easily do that by highlighting and changing it, for example, to a yellow background like this. So it's really useful when you're trying to track your articles and so on. And any photo that you add here is going to be displayed as the cover photo. So let's say that we want to copy this image. We can copy image and go back to our Notion, paste it in. And once you do that and click out, you'll notice that it's going to show up inside of our Resource Hub with Notion article like this. And if we want to review it, you can simply check this off and then you'll see it in your review section. And once you're done reviewing it, you can uncheck it. So in this way, you can keep track of any resources you want to read over. So you could go like this and see them all here. And now that we have this in Notion, we can also add these to the Notion categories as well. So we can, for example, do this. And if we go now to Notion, we'll see these articles pop up here. You can see them by date and you can see whether or not you need to review them. So next, what we wanted to show you is how to use this with Notion's Web Clipper. And this Resource Hub is especially designed to work really well with Web Clipper. So if we go to our Google Chrome here, and we will be sharing the link to the Web Clipper in the description below, but you can install it for Chrome, Safari, or for Firefox. And if we go here, all you need to do to set it up is to basically have this on your browser. And you have to make sure that it is the correct database here. So if we search for resources, right now we named it Resources Preview, but when you do download this, the database name is going to be Resources. So just keep that in mind and make sure you're in the right workspace, and then we can save the page. So now if we go back to our Notion, we're going to see that page added here. So it's the same exact article. And if we open it up, it's automatically added here for you and formatted. So it's very nice how it works. And it even included the URL for you. All you have to do is fill in the type. You would have to make sure to tag it with the correct topic after that. But as you can see, the manual entering of this is not as great as the Web Clipper version here. Next, let's take a look at our AI version and what it includes in the AI version. So with this one, we really wanted to make sure that the capabilities of Notion AI is featured in this template. So let's try to add the same article we did with our other resource hub. So we're just going to add this one manually. So we're going to click plus new, and this is the resources with Notion. Then if we go ahead here, we can just copy everything. And then we can paste it in like this. We can also already put the type, and we can already connect the topic like this. And we can also add the URL. So if we put the URL here like this, then the next step that's really useful with this AI version is that you can simply click the update button. And it gives you this wonderful AI summary so that you can easily check what this is about without having to read the whole entire resource. You can also get 5 review questions by clicking here. For example, what are the benefits of having a digital resource hub? How can you categorize your digital resources? What are some tips for organizing your digital resources effectively? And so on. So this way you can really sort of keep track of your reading comprehension. You can always update it again and check if there's any better AI summary or review questions to keep here, but the AI features really help with your understanding of your resources. We hope that this was useful. If you're interested in this template, we'll leave the links in the description. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to let us know, and we hope to see you all in the next video.